In this video, we are going to solve example 6.5 that is taken from chapter number 6, Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is, draw the shear and movement diagram for the beam shown in figure 6-11A. So you can see this is the figure 6-11A, and there is a cantilever beam having length 2L, and that is having fixed support at this point, and with a point load at the mid of this beam, at the end there is a point load P acting on that. So you have to find the shear force and bending moment diagram. So let's start with the solution. What will be the first step? First step is that if you remove this fixed support at this end, so you will be having a reaction force. Let this is point A, so you will be having reaction force, which is vertical reaction RAY. You will be having a horizontal reaction force, which will be represented as RAX, clear? And you will be having a moment, that is MA, at this point. Now we'll find this RAX, RAY and MA by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium will be, sum of all forces along X direction must be equal to zero, and force toward right is taken as positive. So from this figure you can see only horizontal force is RAX, there is no other force, so it will be equal to zero. So it means that horizontal reaction force is zero. Now we'll find this vertical reaction force by using another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along Y direction must be equal to zero, and upward force is taken as positive. So RAY, which is acting upward, that is positive, minus this first P and this second P. So minus P will be equal to zero. So from here we will get this RAY minus 2 times P is equal to zero. So what we will get is that RAY will be equal to 2P. Okay. Now we'll move toward the third part, and in third part you have to find this moment MA. So for that I will apply equation, sum of all moment about point A is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point A, this force and this force are passing through this point, so they are not producing moment. Only moment producing are this force and this force. So starting from this force, the first force which is producing movement is P into perpendicular distance is 2L, and this is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So I can write P multiplied by 2L, and that is negative. The second movement that is produced due to this load, P into perpendicular distance, is L, and this is also producing clockwise, so it will be negative. I will also write this minus P times L, and the last moment which is acting at A is reaction moment, which is unknown, and that is counterclockwise, so it will be M plus MA. The sum of all these moments about point A will be equal to zero. So I will get minus 2PL minus PL plus M moment about A is equal to zero. So from here this moment about A will be equal to 3PL. Okay, now you have all these values, so we will move toward drawing shear force and bending moment diagram. For that I will draw the vertical lines from the end of this beam. So let me draw it first. Okay, first we will draw the shear force diagram. So for that shear force diagram, what I have to do is that I have to take a horizontal line to show the length L, X, and on Y axis you have shear force, and we will take this force as equal to P. Each force is taken as P, so it will be 2P, it will be 3P. Similarly, minus P, minus 2P, and so on. Okay, starting from the very first point where only reaction force RAY is acting, which is 2P. So first point will be your this 2P. Now moving from this A till this point, there is no other force, so it will remain same. So I will draw a horizontal line, and you can see the horizontal shear force will remain same. But here now you can see you have minus P, which is causing plus 2P minus P will bring it to this point P, and the shear force will change from this 2P to minus P. Okay, so let me write it here 2P, and here this is P. Also, moving from this midpoint till the end, there is no other force, so shear force remain horizontal, but at the end you can see you have minus P acting. So plus P minus P will bring it to the zero. So this will be your shear force diagram. Now we'll draw the bending moment diagram, and again for bending moment diagram you have to draw a horizontal line to show the length, clear? And this is x. X is start from 0 to L, and on y axis you will having bending moment. Let take each bending moment is minus PL, minus 2PL, minus 3PL, and here PL, and above plus 2PL, etc. Okay, at the very first point you can see at point A you have a bending moment MA, which is 3PL, that is positive. So any value of the bending moment which is positive, so while drawing on shear force and bending moment diagram, you have to take it negative, because this moment will cause the bending moment to go downward. So your first point will be this one, minus 3PL. Okay, now we, as we know that area under the shear force diagram will give you bending moment. So first area is this one. You can see this is the first area under the shear force diagram, and this area you can see is rectangle. So its height is 2P and length is L. So 2PL will be the first area at this midpoint. Okay, let me, this is 2PL. So at midpoint we have minus, okay. This area is 2PL. So here you can see minus 3PL. Let me write it over here. Moment at mid of beam will be minus 3PL plus the area under the shear force diagram, which is plus 2PL, and that will give you minus PL. So let me correct it also here. This will be minus PL, and your movement will be somewhere here. This is minus P into L, and you can see that shear force is a horizontal line with 0 degree, and this area is positive, so bending moment will be 1 degree higher. It will be a straight line and slope will be increasing. Okay, now next area under the shear force diagram is this area, and this is also rectangle with height P and length is equal to L, so it will be PL. Okay, so what will be the moment at the end? Moment at end of beam will be minus PL plus area under the shear force diagram, which is shown over here. So this is plus PL. So that will give you zero at the end. So what we will get is zero at the end. And you can see that shear force is a horizontal line with 0 degree. So bending moment will be 1 degree higher, and it will be a straight line by joining these two points. So we will get this bending moment diagram. So this was all about this problem example 6.5, in which we have drawn the shear force and bending moment diagram. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.